Familia, thank you for being here. My name is Juan Ramon Antonio Segarra, aka DJ Salsa Level 1 for WVSLON, Salsa Radio Station, and welcome to the Salsa Level Lounge Hour. Our guests tonight, you know them, are the world famous Los Hermanos Colón. Introduce yourselves.
My name is Marcos Colón. I'm the lead singer of the group, and I've been with the band for over 35 years now. You know, they started as La Constitución, and I joined them when they were already had their first album with another singer, Sergio Quijano. And when Sergio left, I came into the band, and it's been a pleasure to ride with my brothers.
Fantastic. Welcome, Marco.
Thank you. My name is Herb Colón. Es un placer estar aquí con ustedes. Estoy un poquito ronco, pero estoy en parte de la cosa hoy. Man, it's a pleasure. I'm the founder of Hermanos Colón. My brother Freddy was the first Colón that joined the band with me. Then Marcus came in. So my name is Herb Colón. Un placer de conocer ustedes.
Thank you, Hollywood.
He's Hollywood. Yeah. My name is Alfredo Colón. They call me Freddy for Hermanos Colón.
And we have also a great legend in promotions from back in the day. We're bringing him out of retirement. The great, it's his production, Tony Ortiz production, Mr. Tony Ortiz.
Welcome to my house. Mi casa es su casa.
Let's let it go. You guys ready? Yeah. Okay, people, we're gonna rock and roll with these guys because we know them very well. So you introduce yourself, okay? My first question, who inspired you to come into the salsa scene?
Who inspired me to come into the salsa scene? I would say my father, who's a musician. He had his own band, La Sonora 77, Mike Hernandez. You know, my first inspiration, and of course my brothers. You know, when they put out their first album, and I saw that they put out a great album, which was produced by Sergio George through Mambo Little Records, I said, man, this is, I gotta do this. I gotta join my brothers.
And you got bit.
And I got bitten, and since then I love Latin music. I love everything about it. You know, and I'm here thanks to my brothers. You know, I wouldn't be doing this. I would probably be doing rock and roll or singing country music, you know?
Nothing wrong with country music. For what country?
Right, exactly. So I stuck to my roots, my Puerto Rican roots.
Herman?
Yes.
Who inspired you?
Who inspired me? Like my brother said, my dad. My mother, she was a singer too. It ran in the family. We had a group of musicians. On crews, everybody.
You couldn't escape it then.
Yeah, we couldn't do it. Everything was in the family. Cousins, everybody was involved. So we all got inspired, but one of the bands that really, you know, that really got me going was Joe Cuba. I mean, I remember coming from Puerto Rico, going to Central Park, and seeing Joe Cuba on stage, and he was just saying, testing to every man. And I said, man, well, this guy's gonna stop playing. But he had one thing, he always wanted to make sure his music was good. So we're there 20 minutes and this guy going back and forth testing 6 mics. But when this band, these 6 guys, he pounded that band, I said, oh my God, this is what I really wanted to do.
They were something to see, boy. So you gotta give it up to Joe Cuba. Man.
And at that time, you know, I was a percussionist. I was a conguero, and Freddy used to play bongos. And at that time, the band was La Constitución de Hermanos Colón. The Hermanos Colón wasn't created yet. You know, we was, you know, playing the music, but there was a band that we was listening to. Willie Colón, you know, like I said, all these bands, but what inspired me was Joe Cuba. When that man got on stage, that was in Central Park. And that was awesome.
He had Cheo, right?
Yeah, he had Cheo.
Cheo, Jimmy.
He had all those, you know.
Jimmy Salakian.
Yeah. You know?
They had one of the tightest sounds, you know what I mean?
They did have the tightest sounds.
It was like
It was like a train coming at you.
It sounded like an orchestra, but it was just six guys. It was just six steps, and they cooked.
Yeah, they were really good. So those guys got me going. So that's one of the people that inspired me. Like I said, my mother. And la música puertorriqueña, la música, you know, tradición puertorriqueña, we listen to that in my house all the time. Yeah. Willie Colon, like Christmas songs, you know, it was the same song, but it was bad.
Yeah, it was funny. Now, I remember that we used to do a lot of stuff, like we were doing duo. Like if we were doing, you know, like, what was that song? It's the, la 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 la. We used to do that. We used to go to the family and all hang out and do that. It was almost like doing duo for us, you know? And great memories, man.
House parties.
Yeah.
They don't have them anymore. No. Too many people in the house. But back then, we used to fill the house with the whole building.
Oh, you're right. Yeah. I mean, we used to live in 197, when we came, it was in the Bronx, in 197 in Decatur Avenue. And our rehearsal was in the roof.
Yeah,
I mean, the whole block. We used to come up to our rehearsal, but, you know, La Constitución, and we used to rehearse up there. I mean, we didn't have no problem with the landlord coming up knocking on the door. No, you can't do this. We used to rehearse up there in the roof, and everybody in the whole neighborhood would come up there and, you know, have a good time.
No wonder your first album sold out.
That's it.
The whole neighborhood bought it.
And then another habit that we had, you know, like I said, my mother was very inspired because we would sit on the table, you know, and I would hit on the table, and then my mother started doing her music and he stopped banging before, you know, we had a nice thing going. So, like I said, mom was the one that got me going. But I'm going to pass it back to my brother Freddie because I know he got so much nice to say.
Freddie?
There's nothing I can say. There's
so quiet.
No, the one that inspired me was my mom's. It was my mom's. Then my father. So then
we spoke with your father in the first interview, and he had quite a career, but you were like mom's boy, and she was a hell of a singer too.
Yeah, because it was, you know, in my family, it was the whole tradition, Christian tradition, Fiesta de Maria, Una Promesa. Right. We did this in my house. All my family used to come, we used to sing. Everybody used to sing. Everybody was a singer. For my aunts, cousins, that we thought they were, maybe, I thought they were my sisters, but they were cousins because they all grew up, we were younger. They were all singers. And we had this tradition in my house. Every year, you had 30, 40, 50 people coming to the house, a una promesa. Yo te sabré María llena de gracia, all these stuff was going on. That's how we learned. Because we used to play.
It was for Bol Bembe.
Yes, for Bol Bembe. This is one of the traditions that we had. Then I found out that my father had a band, and sometimes we used to go to a rehearsal when we was in, when they used to rehearse in 96 in a casino. When we was young, we used to go. And I remember meeting, and I was young, Paquito Guzmán. I remember seeing my father telling me, this is
Daniel
Santo. This is Pico de Rodríguez, all these guys, you know, Tito Puente, you know, all we met. I remember all these things.
Where I'm from?
You know, this is a tradition. Yeah, you know, I had an uncle, Papo Colón, who played Tito Puente like 45 years, percussion. You know, then I got another uncle, Fanta. He played with La Mayari, one of the best conjunto in Puerto Rico. You know, Fanta Hernández, Rafael Hernández, that was his name too. But this is the tradition that we learned, you know, with these people, because they were good musicians, they knew what they were doing.
Tony.
I don't think we have enough time.
What inspired you to get into the promotional side of music?
La mujer.
No. I hope she's not listening. So.
But you know, really, what the way I see it, when I was young, I was 16 years old, and I started doing gigs. We used to play hooky and then go to somebody's home where parents was working, and I hate to say this, but it's the honest truth. And that's how we started, and then that's how I started. And then it got so popular that I had to start renting the space in every neighborhood. There was a bar, and in the back it had a big room.
The After Hour Club.
here, then that's, I used to rent it for $50. Cobraba en la puerta, I started doing that. And that got too big, and then I had to start looking for bigger places. And for some reason, me parado. Even Mario knows, because we have the best, biggest after hours in the history of nightclubs.
I'm glad you mentioned it, because in our audience, we have Mr. Mario Serrano from Mr. Mario Fashion Store, who's coming up to join us. Because if anyone had a hot spot, it was Mr. Mario's club. And the one in Williamsburg was so hot that the minute we got off the train station, the fire department used to hold us down before we went in.
4 o'clock in the morning.
Hello.
At 4 o'clock in the morning, all the cops from the night of, and we're going off duty, and we're heading my way to meet the Colombians and the Bonteros and the Vaqueros.
They had to split the cut.
He mentioned Joe Cuba. He mentioned Joe Cuba. I have a lot of stories with Joe Cuba.
Tell us a joke.
Joe Cuba. I had a supper club in Atlantic City in 79, and he was my house band for 10 weekends in a row. Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, it all went home.
So that.
And we put him in a guest house with everybody else, and he had roaches coming out. And he started yelling, I said, well, let's do the Boys College Hotel. And we made that number.
and that's how it started, huh? The bachata began because they were killing cockroaches upstate.
So could you imagine? I think I'm the only one who has taken Puente's pants off and helped him put the new ones on. I used to dress up in Madison.
Yes, Mr. Mario was the haberdashery of the golden era of
Saturday. Fabulous 70s.
Yeah. It was like you was the man.
For my birthday at my club, Hector Lavo, with Pulpo. Yeah. I talked to him the other day.
He's back to Gogo. Similarly to you guys?
Oh, very good friend.
Yeah, he's a fantastic.
Did he play with my father's band too, back in the 70s also?
As a kid too, right?
He started playing with my father's band. He was here for my birthday.
Yeah. You see, these guys are a university of music. I love this. So,
I'll tell you, my store was on the first floor, with Broadway and Avenue, and the club was 2 floors up.
Yeah.
But when I opened it, it was first Puerto Rican department store in New York City. And I had men's, I had women's, I had jeans, I had a hair shop, and I had a shoe department that I leased to my buddy, Ramon Castro, from Conjunto Clásico.
From Conjunto Clásico.
Zapatos, was it called Zapatos?
Zapatos.
And then he went and bought a rod and he opened up another one. He said, Mary, give me a name. I said, Ropa Zapatos, because he was so close.
He was your manager, right? He managed one of your stores.
No, I leased to the shooting session.
Ah, okay.
So he was my tenant, really. And my buddy, we still are.
Yeah.
I visited him in City High once.
Well, you're supposed to be here, right? But he's a busy guy.
Never confirmed.
You guys are cooking. And here's what I want to know. You guys, any new projects? Because your album, your last album, and you guys are on the cover all dressed in black and walking real cool. Say, yeah, let me put this on. And I just decided to clean up a little around the clubhouse, and when that album started, I was done in like 10 minutes. That was one smoking album. So what are you guys doing now? Any new projects?
As of right now, we're trying to look for a Christmas album. You know, the Manos Colo, we've been out here, we don't have a Christmas album. We have one song, Si Me Dan Pastel, Me Tenía Tardilla. You know? So we are definitely working right now with trying to get a Christmas album now. Hopefully after that, we're going to work on another album. Our priority right now is to get our first album and Christmas album.
You think
hopefully it becomes it's a Christmas album. Hopefully it becomes like Willie Colon's album. You know, that's a tradition album. Every year, every record shop
says it
now. Aside from Navideño, the
one and two.
The best seller. So we're trying to see if we can do something like that. With all the respect that I have for Willie Colon, because, you know, what he's done in this industry has been, for me, wonderful. But this is what my middle school and I'm working on right now. Hopefully we can have a Christmas album out.
And he was from your neighborhood?
Well, he was from the Bronx, yeah. He grew up in the Bronx and stuff like that. He was more like Decatur Avenue, Fordham. He was on the other side.
On the other side.
He was in the east side. And he was on the south side.
Yeah.
All right.
But when he was running for politics, if we were still in the neighborhood, you know, we would play his music. But we wasn't, you know, once he started running politics, it was happening.
Okay. Okay, that works. That
so
works.
That's what the middle school is working on right now. Trying to get a Christmas album together, and that's what's going on. That's our main goal right now.
Okay, here's a good one. Huh? In terms of recording, nowadays, where have all the record labels gone? I mean, what's finally like, it swallows up everybody. Inca, Tico, Alegre. It's how is music being made today and put out there so we can grab hold of it?
Well, you know, like you said, we don't have La Fania. We don't have a Mambo Little record that recorded our first album. So right now, we are the artist, the producer. We have a whole bunch of ads. We got to go out there and sell our product. You know, and I would say, we do need a company out there. Because when you had La Fania, Salsa was booming.
Pay attention, Tommy. This was for you.
When you had, Rafi Mercado,
exactly.
He was booming. He had, you know, our music was being played.
Yeah.
Los Hermanos Colón, we record an album, we go to a radio station, we take our stuff, and the megas, you know, we cannot afford to keep our music playing or doing it because we're not a major company. I mean, when we first recorded, thank God we recorded, and this man had a lot to do with it, but Hermanos Colón, people don't know, Tony.
Preach.
Yeah.
Preach.
He was the first one that actually recorded Los Hermanos Colón. And a lot of people don't know. My first album was under his label, Mambo Little Records. Okay? And like everything,
I don't say.
Right.
So you was the Jerry Masucci Pacheco before there was Jerry Masucci Pacheco.
That's what I was right?
But this
is
Tony pulled your hair out. Get me another album.
He did what he had to do, you know. I thank him because he, like I said, the company that he founded with some other people. Opposed to Hermanos Colón. At that time, we was working with Paquito Guzmán. We was so we was doing coro for Paquito Guzmán. So the Hermanos Colón wasn't created yet. Until we got in contact, he got in contact with us, and we worked it out. And we changed the band. We left Paquito Guzmán because we was a backup band for Paquito Guzmán.
Okay.
So once we started working on a new album, we had to leave all that because now we are dedicated to Los Hermanos Colón.
And they wanted to know why we wanted Tony Ortiz up here. Tony Ortiz wanted to know where you gotta go up here.
Yeah, so, and not only that, we was able, when we did our first album, get one of the best producers to produce our album, thanks to Tony, was Sergio George. At that time, Sergio George, you know.
He was a kid.
Yeah, and he still is.
Yeah, that's true. He is a young guy.
He's a man.
Wow.
So at that time, he was with Rafa Macau. You know?
Yeah.
And that's why, you know, I'm saying that, and now that you're going back to your question, this is what we don't have now. We don't have a major company to go out there and do the work for Los Hermanos Colón like we would like to have, you know? Instead of we having a million hats, we get tired. You know, you've got to go to the studio.
Well,
now,
this is why I say, and Margaret says it all the time, give us what you've got,
It goes on our radio station, and you guys have heard.